sheep. Forgive us an example in following so trustingly the Good Shepherd. We thank you for the lambs who live among us, giving us so much joy. And most of all, we thank you for the Lamb of God, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And now number 56, verses 3 and 4, right? All right. God, now and forever. Amen. sacred scriptures.
A reading from the book of Malachi. See, I'm sending my messenger to prepare the way before me, and the Lord, whom you seek, will suddenly come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant in whom you delight. Indeed, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who can endure the day of his coming? And who can stand when he appears? For he is like a refiner's fire, like a fuller's soap. He will sit as a refiner and a purifier of silver, and he will purify the descendants of Levi and refine them by gold and silver until they are present offerings to the Lord in righteousness. Then the offering of Judah and Jerusalem will be pleasing to the Lord as in the days of old and as the former years. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel.
He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior,
born of the house of the servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies,
from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers,
and to remember his holy covenant.
This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham,
to set us free from the hands of our enemies,
free to worship him without fear,
holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our lives.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High.
For you will go before the Lord to hear every way,
to give his people knowledge of salvation,
by the forgiveness of their sins,
in the tender compassion of our God,
the dawn from our eyes shall break upon us,
to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death,
and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Continue with a reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you, because of your sharing in the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to think this way about all of you, because you hold me in your heart. For all of you, sharing God's grace with me, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the compassion of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may overflow more and more with the knowledge and full insight to help you to determine what is best, so that the day of Christ you may be pure and blameless, having produced the harvest of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, for the glory and praise of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Turning your book to Philippians, verse 6-7. We'll sing verses 1 and 2 from the gospel and verse 3 after.
the 15th year of the reign of Emperor Tiberius, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, and Herod was ruler of Galilee, and his brother Philip, ruler of Iturea and Trachonitis, and Licinius, ruler of Abilene, three, the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas. The word of God came to John, son of Zechariah, in the wilderness. He went into all regions around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah, the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill will be made low, and the crooked will be made straight, and rough ways made smooth, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The problem with the Gospels is we make them antiseptic. they're read to us in this context, and it's like, oh, well, I'm going to make every path straight. I'm going to take the hills down and make everything smooth, and that'll be just great. You ever see construction? You ever drive through it? It's a lot of fun, right? They don't grip and rip and tear everything apart. We go to Manitowoc quite a bit, and on Highway 23, they're making it four lanes from Fond du Lac to Sheboygan. It has been a certified pain in the tuchus for 2 or 3 years. But now it's almost done, and let me tell you, it saves about 20, 25 minutes on your trip. It's wonderful. But it wasn't without its pain. And they took huge amounts of earth, and they changed it, and they recontoured the land. That's what John's talking about. That's what God's talking about. And that is the story of at least my life. One time, I was praying, and I said, God, because the whole, the potter's hands, you know, the clay, make me into the vessel. And so I said, God, use me. And he said, then I'm going to have to smash you so I can repurpose you. And I said, that sounds like it's going to hurt. And he said, it might. And I said, okay. Okay. No one ever told us that giving our heart to Christ was going to give us an easy life. Everybody who comes to me 2 weeks after they give their heart to Christ says, but it's not any better. I gave my heart to Christ. Why isn't everything cool? That was never the promise. The promise is, I will never abandon you. I will give you the gifts you need to answer the call. I will hold you in the palm of my hand, and you will not suffer alone. Notice that it doesn't say you will not suffer. It says you will not suffer alone. And like that mule, I often feel not only my life, but sometimes my God is trying to bury me alive, to reuse me and repurpose me. And I don't understand. Because I'm a good guy. I try really hard. I love you. I love my family. I do everything I can. Why is this still so hard? Why can't it just be easy sometimes? Anybody else ever say that? Yes. God says, if we listen to the scriptures, you know, that's the thing about the scriptures, is we love to quote it, but quoting it and living it are two different things. God says, I will be with you to the end of the age. God says that in order to use you most fully, I must recreate you. And God never, ever says that that's going to be without his pain. In fact, unless the grain of wheat falls to the earth and dies, it cannot be born again. And so in this process of all things living and dying, it's not just physical death that we go through. And in the season of Advent, we draw ourselves to the light. And in the first reading, it talks about purifying us. And in order to make silver or gold pure, what do? They heat it. The fuller soap. What do you do with soap? Hopefully you take it into the bath or shower with you. I'm not like my boys, just leave it outside and figure out that running around the shower and having it close to you is good enough. We are being prepared for something. We are being recreated in God's image. And in this season of preparation for the birth of the King, the more you prepare, the more glorious your celebration will be. Because the King changes everything. And it's not going to be easy. But the good news is, not only are you not going to be alone because of God, the faith community that you live and breathe in is also part of that solution. So I've had a funeral, and I've had a baptism, and I've had a wedding in the last 3 days. And the majority of the people that I was with do not do this. Is that okay? It is. Did they have the gospel preached to them? Do they know where to go if they need to? And do they understand that someone is praying for them right now? That's our job. We can fret. We can say, what a shame. We can shake our heads. You can even text that now, shake my head. My kids taught me that. Or we can do the work. Roll up our sleeves and prepare. Light the candles, say the prayer, and remember, not only us, but all those who we touched, who we've been with during the week. In morning prayer this morning, the prayer for Sunday says, prepare me, Lord, for the week to come, that I may be your vehicle in the world. I think it's a pretty powerful prayer. Because John cries out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Who's he talking to? Us. He's talking to us, the faithful, who hear his words and are to respond to it. Now, is perfection the goal? Not mine. Not my view. It's not about being perfect. It is about being faithful. It is about emptying your heart and listening to the Kyrie and the confession and saying, I dropped the ball quite a bit this week. I'll try to drop it a little less next week. It is about quieting ourselves from time to time in the busyness of our lives to hear the cry of the poor and the voice of our God. And together, in his holy presence, we become holy. We become changed. It's one of the things I love about our church, is that I get as many Advents as I'm alive to keep doing this transformation. God doesn't expect me to have it right tomorrow. God knows that I will probably need 150 Advents and Lents and a lot more to get ballpark close. And I will, with every fiber of my being, one of the things that beloved Tommy, who we buried on Thursday, taught me was what it means to not give up. To fight for every ounce of life that you have and to use it well to continue to teach the lessons that God has entrusted to us. That is the story of Advent. That is the story of Christ. And that is the story of us in the church. May we be holy lights to all we meet, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. On page 358 in the Book of Common Prayer, the Red Book, please rise if you're able. 358. St. Mike, what do we believe?
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were Lord, glorify all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
Especially remembering the Right Reverend Michael Curry, our presiding bishop, the Right Reverend Jeffrey Lee, our provisional bishop, Father Mike Kess, our priest in charge, Meredith, our postulant and seminarian, and for all bishops and other ministers, that they may be faithful ministers
of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest, especially remembering Tom Guttel.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
What should we pray for this day?
Community of Oxford High School.
For my mom.
Oh, go ahead.
For my mom, for Kayla and Joel, who were just married yesterday, for Oscar, who was baptized yesterday, 2 days ago, for Tommy and his family, strength for his family.
My husband, Dan, having surgery tomorrow.
And for Marie.
For those who are sick and their caregivers, Robin and Tim, Ernie and Joyce, Marcia and Bob, Corey and Dave, Paul and Betsy, Amy and Julie, Al and Martha, Nancy and Clayton, Josh, Terry, Don, Martha, Nick, Dave, Robert, Frank, and Jack. We also ask prayers for all the health care workers. For those serving in the armed forces, especially Dennis Adams, John Baylor, Perry Hilbert's deployed, Pat Hoffman, Lindsay, Brian Lampert, Christopher Schobel, John Wyro deployed, Noah Harnbacher, and Trevor. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. For those who are celebrating their birthdays this week, especially Sue Kuhn, James Merrill Jr., Sophia Wester, Bambi Tischer, and for those celebrating their baptismal anniversaries this week, especially remembering Summer Helmer, and those celebrating their wedding anniversary.
We also remember Bob Boyer's aunt and Mark Bremer's aunt and uncle, Aaron, whose back is still giving her a hard time. All of our firefighters, EMS, police officers, all doctors and nurses, all those who need a special prayer, especially those who are suffering from the new variant of the virus, and all those in whom that brings great anxiety. Gracious God, watch over us and bless us. Answer our prayers as only you can. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The confession can be found on page 360. Let us confess our sin against God and neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have not done. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we repent. For the sake
God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please rise if you're able. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you. Please exchange with one another a sign, a COVID-friendly sign of peace. Everlasting life.
that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the whole world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voice with angels and archangels, with Saint Benedict, Saint Francis, Saint Thomas, Saint Mark, and the Blessed Virgin Mary, and the whole company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took a cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit, to be for your people the body and the blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new, unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity and constancy and in peace. At the last day, bring us, with Mark and all your saints, into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through him, with him, and him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
words our Savior taught us, we're bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ, our Passover sacrifice for us.
Therefore, let us eat the peace. Hallelujah.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us thy peace.
My brothers and sisters, the gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and beat on in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. All baptized Christians are welcome at communion in the Episcopal Church. If you need a gluten-free host, please let me know and I will take care of that. Please join us at the table.
Thank you.
65 and your Red Book of Comfort, 360 Comfort. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father,
you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have fed us with spiritual food and the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Healing and strengthening, or for birthdays or anniversaries, for you or one you love, please come to the middle. Go back to front.
I ask for prayers for all of the bakers, the box putters, all the people who have put forth time and effort and prayer for our up-and-coming cookie sale as we celebrate the 33rd year of doing this. And we have no idea how absolutely thrilled I am to be a part of that.
Gracious God, bless all the cookie bakers and eaters and preparers and boxers. May they understand how they are used by God through this ministry. May they continue to grow and flourish. May they be protected and blessed. And may this bring great joy to those who bake and those who eat. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Here's one. Oh, yeah. A birthday boy. Aren't we the same age? You're just a little older than me. Just a little older. He's better looking, but I'm a little older. Gracious God, we urge him, continue to watch over him, keep him as the holy light that he is. May this year be blessed. May all his wishes come true. May he be kept from all that harm him, and may this next year be a great year of joy, especially with the wedding of your daughter and all the other momentous events. May God bless you and keep you for the Son and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
His daughter, just like yesterday, Kayla, since Kayla was me on your grasshopper, I was going to her wedding. I was going to be the only priest going to her wedding. They both went it three times, and I still was always the guy. And his daughter, same thing. She doesn't know, there's lots of things that she doesn't know, but she does know that God only gets to go on her wedding. So, healing, may the doctors and nurses use their gifts in a way pleasing to you and keep him from all that would harm and bring him back to fullness of life and give you strength as you walk up and through this. Through Christ the Lord. Tell him I'm praying for him. And if you need me, let me know. I can? Yep, I certainly can. Anybody else? Mary, do you want to be home? Couple more, yeah. Mary's shoulder and her family, may God watch over you and bless you, protect you, and heal you. Thank you, God, for bringing Mary back into our midst and continue to keep her in your steadfast protection. Heal her shoulder and help this family as they grieve the loss of her brother. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For James Jr.'s birthday.
That's your son, right?
Yeah.
Gracious God, watch over James Jr. and give him the gift of joy. May all his wishes come true. May he be kept in steadfast protection, and may this be his best year of the Holiness of Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Anything else? Just announcements. Yes, John, you're up. What do you got?
If you have not ordered your box of cookies, I am still taking orders. Let let me know today, or if you have friends who want to order them, they can email us or call me. The number is out on the booth or on the sign, or look it up in your directory.
How many orders are unfulfilled?
How many orders are unfulfilled?
How much are we down? How much are we down from last year?
36, I think.
We're at 36?
I think we're at 36. Last year we had like 66.
Ooh.
Yeah, so spread some good word, please. We got cookies happening. So to follow up on and piggyback this, if you are a baker, please bring your cookies Thursday afternoon or evening. I'll just be here.
Can they drop them off Wednesday?
Probably. Yeah, actually.
That's what we hear.
So Wednesday night or Thursday afternoon or pretty much all day, I'll just be here. Then could use some help with putting boxes together would be great. And if you are ordering, then please pick up your boxes of cookies, filled and happy and yummy, on Saturday morning between 9 and 10, right here. And I think that is all I have to say about that. Oh,
what's your box making day?
Box making day is Friday afternoon.
Oh. 1 o'clock, right?
You got it, yeah.
We're off to the races with soup and bread for Advent Wednesdays, and we went through the Advent Station of the Cross, and I'm adjusting, but they went pretty darn well, all in all. I got to be part of Meredith's Friday gathering for just a short bit in between the morning practice and the dinner. Really, really cool, nice turnout, good soup. So those are two really great opportunities for you.
I would also say that there are a few more of the Living Compass Advent devotional books that are back there. Please take one. They are paid for, so just grab one and go. You don't have to join us on Friday night. You're welcome to. If you are interested, I'll find a way to Zoom you in. Just let me know, and I'll set that up and send you a link. But it's a great study even to do it on your own. So it's just a great way to prepare and have some spiritual engagement through Advent.
I did what Meredith said, and I picked up the book, and I'm just kind of reading it on my own, and it's really, really good. Linda?
There are still t-shirts to be picked up downstairs in the fireside room. If you've ordered one and haven't picked it up, today's your day. If you haven't ordered one and want one, there are still some extras that we ordered down there that you can take a look at. If you want lion's fruit, like we did usually every year, I'm not doing it this year, but you can still get it at the building across the street from La Tapatia Mexican Restaurant. It was the old Cabela's store. It's got Snap Fitness in it and a beauty shop along that side. 111 East Burnett Street is the address. They are selling it from their loading dock on the 8th, the 9th, and the 10th of December. $24 a box. Like usual, for oranges, grapefruit, or a mixed box. And you just have to say that the guy that you're buying for is Floyd Henschel. But Meredith has a wonderful e-news advertisement. So look up her e-news from each week, and she has the information on there.
I thought you said lion's fruit, and I'm like, okay, I gotta know what lion's fruit is.
The lion's fruit.
Oh, lion's fruit, so it is lion's fruit.
It is lion's fruit.
I thought it was some special kind of fruit I'd never heard of.
Because they're not.
Oh, the camel getting the lead?
The camel knows the way.
Yeah, okay. Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Number 529.
529. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Amen. Amen.